Now, if I were to tell you that the way you present your pellet into the breech of a piston-powered air gun can actually affect its downrange accuracy and even its power up or down, you might think that I've gone bananas. But the fact is, that really can happen. So on a very drizzly autumn afternoon, I'm going to spend a couple of hours proving that using my 177 Feinwerkbau Master Sport and this 2.2 Webley VMX OS Quantum. Now, the test itself is relatively straightforward because I've taken four brands of pellet, each in 177 and 2.2, and I'm going to seat them into the breeches of the two rifles using these special gadgets. The Beeman PellSeat, which I've had for some time now, and also this little gadget that I made myself out of a nut, a bolt and a ball bearing. Oh, and of course, I'm going to be using this. I've got myself a stack of targets and I'm going to spend the next few hours assessing what differences it makes to accuracy whether I seat the pellet with my thumb normally or whether I use my DIY pellet seating tool or the Beeman PellSeat.
For the accuracy element of the exercise, I zeroed each rifle at 25 yards and then fired off three shot strings with each of the sample ammo using each of the three pellet seating methods. I did an auto zero and always aimed at the bull. With accuracy the objective, I adopted a field target overarm hold, which I favour when grouping with a recoiling springer. During the actual pellet seating tests, I documented on camera a few things of note.
Now, straight off the bat, there are a couple of things that I'm noticing, particularly with the Webley VMX, which has a power lock mainspring inside. When I use the Beeman PellSeat, the pellets are being pushed so far down inside the rifling that there seems to be no air seal. So when I pull the trigger, the piston crashes into the end of the cylinder, creating an awful lot of vibration.
And that vibration was having a detrimental effect at the target. Press the pause button and you'll clearly see that the PellSeat tool caused groups to open up and strike low, while my DIY pellet seater achieved gold stars across the board for improving the 2.2 rifle's accuracy. As the day's testing continued, it was the turn of the 177s to catch my eye.
So I'm halfway through my testing at the moment, and one thing I have noticed is that 177 Kaiser pellets are incredibly accurate out of my Feinwerkbau, and I think that is down to the chamfer at the breech face.
You see, you don't want this, your pellet skirt, to stand proud of the breech face when you've thumbed it home. In fact, I've used a very fine conical grinding stone turned by hand to add a deeper chamfer into my Feinwerkbau's breech, and this allows pellets to thumb home flush. And the results show that this rifle's accuracy doesn't really improve if the pellets are seated. Plus, those groups remain worst with the Beeman. Press pause again to have a longer look, and then we'll go on to the next element of this test.
Right, let's see if pellet seating makes a difference to the power.
I use my Combro Cb-625 Mark IV chronoscope to check each rifle's output with the sample pellets when seated by each of the three methods. And as you'll see, there was far more variation with how pellet seating affected power than it did accuracy. Pause these 2.2 results for closer analysis, and the 177 results will follow them when you resume play. And finally,
can we say categorically that seating your pellets into a piston-powered air gun will improve its performance? The answer is no, not categorically. However, based on today's evidence, we can say that with the right combination of pellet, rifle and pellet seating tool, it might make a difference. And if that means I can get some extra accuracy or greater power, well, I'm certainly going to give it a go.
If you want to see more stuff like this on AirgunTV, please like the video. And if you've experimented with pellet seating, post a comment to let us know your findings.